sing? I can try and sing. Shire's supposed to sing when he's up here. Shire kind of screwed things up.
Freaking Shire.
Yeah, he just like hasn't shown up to anything.
Oh, nice.
So, yeah. And I am not good at singing.
I think it's different. I think you're good at singing.
Oh, yeah.
We can't talk about it tomorrow. We have to twice. Or if, well, so if somebody's singing, we'll do the revise. So we'll do just revise and then singing and then all of us out. But if
Rocky Top, Tennessee. Rocky Top, Tennessee. And that's just how it is. Okay. That's really easy.
Cool.
So you actually go through
the. Do
you
want to do the chorus one more time?
Yeah, do one more time, then we'll start.
Then you do this part twice.
Or do you want to do the whole thing, or?
We just do like the last chorus.
Okay, sounds good.
Yeah.
Yeah. So Daisy, when they're done, you can hit those lights, okay, girl? Yeah. And then when she hits those lights, spot me in. Liamski, hopefully you're ready.
Okay.
Alright, so.
Hello and welcome to Coeur d'Alene Charter Academy's production of The Foreigner, written by Larry Shue and directed by Dana Fleming. At this time, I would like to ask you to please silence all cell phones and turn off all recording devices. Thank you and please enjoy the show. My first time here as a guest instructor to the American Army, and the most famous place to stay is where I landed it here. Told the sweet old lady in the parlor a few of my stories from around the world, and well, here we are, some 13 odd years later, eh? Here we go then, Charlie, here we go. This is your place, all right. Hello! Betsy, my love! Excellent. Time to make it. Well, that's nice, I shouldn't think. Hello! Got far with the door wide open like that. Fire in the grate. Unless it's like one of those ghost ships, eh? No, there you'll be down directly and we'll have ourselves a nice cup of something hot, eh? That's a nice one. Make yourself comfortable for your mouth, shall we? Put another lug in that pocket. Like bed and breakfast, innit? Guest room suit there. Hot meals, cheerfully prepared by the widow meets herself. Bar. But one for you, Charlie. I never drink alone. If I can help it. Right, light yourself up, gum. Right, let's see. London to Atlanta, there we are. Picked up the jeep right around here. 100 miles south on the motorway. There's the lake, Charlie. Just beautiful on the day like the lake is. See right from that window if you can. Do what you need, your own forest retreat. Silent, peaceful, eh? What do you think?
I shouldn't have come.
Now.
No, I don't think me ungrateful, Froggy. I know the enormous trouble you've taken to bring me here.
No, it was no trouble. You know what I told the Yanks? I told them he's my assistant. If he don't go, I don't go. And 1 minute later, bingo, on the plane together.
Yes, you're such assistant. That was a good joke.
It's all about my approach, you see? The right approach, that's all.
Yes, still.
What?
I should have stayed with Mary at the hospital. When a man's wife is dying, he belongs with her, not in Georgia.
I will only be here 3 days.
Still, with only 6 months left. 6 months before she...
Now, doctors have been wrong before. But besides which, Mary wanted you to come here with her. Fairly begged me to take it, she did.
Yes, and so I agree.
And she was right. The way he was hanging about that hospital, pining away, he was looking worse than what she did. She was worried for you.
Oh, Froggy.
She was, I can see it in her eyes.
I don't think worry was what you saw in Mary's eyes.
Well, of course it was.
Oh, Froggy. For someone I see so little, you're such a good... Ren, I'm so bad at talking to people, but I think you ought to know. Mary doesn't like me very much.
Go on.
No. The fact is, she finds me boring.
No.
Yes. That's why she wants me to leave, you see. She simply finds me shatteringly, profoundly boring.
So now why would she think that, eh?
Oh, because I am. I know it. There, I've sat behind my grey little proofreader's desk for 17 years now. I sometimes wonder whether a science fiction magazine even needs a proofreader. Does anyone really care whether there's 1K or 2 in Klaatu, Barada, Nihtu? No, no, I'm boring, all right. I've often wondered, how does one acquire personality? What must it be like to be able to tell a funny story? To arouse laughter, anger, respect, to be thought wise. How must it be?
Well, you're a good officer.
Not much of a trick in peacetime.
You can't get away from wars. You would face the enemy fire with the best if you had to.
That is something I shall always wonder.
Well, don't wonder. And don't wonder about Mary either. I don't know her very well, but I look alike what she is. She's had chances. She could have cast her eye on some of the blokes, but she never has. Now, has she? Has she?
Oh.
Now.
Yes.
All right, so what, you got to flirt with some bloke, that's it? Got to make an eyes with some bloke?
Yes.
Where was it?
The shower.
Oh, God.
Yes.
Well, all right. Happens in the best of marriages, eh? One little mistake, one little dalliance, that's no more reason for you to... More than once? More than twice? Well, how many times, then?
23.
Now!
More or less.
Mary?
Yes.
I don't believe it.
Well... Actors, writers, all the glamorous professions, you see. Criminals, veterinarians.
And did you know?
Oh, yes. Mary wanted me to. She flaunted them at me.
I don't believe it. And after all that, I mean, after all that, you still...
love her more than anything on earth. Love is not love, Froggy, which alters when it alteration finds.
No, no. Who said that?
Shakespeare.
Ah, he could turn a phrase, couldn't he?
Yes.
Love is not love, Froggy, which... What was it again?
Which alters when it alteration finds.
Yes, quite true.
He didn't say Froggy.
No, no, of course he wouldn't. And have you talked to anyone else about this?
I've tried to, but I'm no good at it, you see. Talk. One is expected to talk these things out, but I can't seem to... I never finish sentences. I have an active fear of
talk.
Yes, lately. Even idle conversation terrifies me. Simply knowing that in the next moment, it's going to be my turn again. My turn to
talk.
Yes.
Well, you won't have to worry about that either. I bet you'll blow the talking for the both of you.
What?
Oh, she's a regular chow box. Bet you is good weather, bad weather. How's your mum?
Oh, God.
She's not gone on about some of the other guests, Robbie, so not...
Other guests?
Well...
You mean strangers?
Well, there won't be strangers long. Why, as soon as you've had one or two...
Conversations?
Charlie.
Take me with you, please. Please, try to understand. I can't talk to anyone right now. Please.
I can't bring a civilian on post. You know that. Charlie? Oh, God. Oh, Charlie. All right. You don't want to have to talk to anyone? All right. I'll fix it for you. I've brought you here. I'll make it right for you. If it's no conversation you'll want, it's no conversation you'll have, eh? Royal treatment. Bass drawn, meals set out. Not word spoken, not word acquired, all right?
But they'll think of you rude.
No. I can make Betty love the idea if I put it right. It's all about my approach, you see? The right approach. Well, I'll think of something. Yeah. Number 7. Now, you go make yourself comfortable. I'll find bed, and we'll have tea in a minute.
But she won't speak to me.
I've told you, nobody in this house will speak to you for the next 3 days, or you can talk me to corporal. My word on it. Off. Oh, God, what have I done? Oh, well. Help you, miss.
Oh, I'm getting you all wet.
Oh, I've been wet before. You remind me a bit of Malaysia.
Oh, who's she?
No, it's a place. Look. I brought you something.
Oh. One second.
That's right.
Oh, you know I love spoons.
That's right, I know. Bit for you to get some of these, you know?
Where'd you get this one here?
Ooh, I was given that one by the Aborigines of Canada.
Oh, my land, ain't that something?
Yes, and where do you suppose this one's from?
Oh, I don't know.
The mysterious East.
Ooh, made in Taiwan.
That's right.
Oh, bro, that the places you've been, the people you've seen, it just takes my breath away. Where'd you get this one here?
Tijuana.
Ooh, sounds dangerous.
Oh, it is, yes.
I tip this one over and all their clothes come off.
Well, they're heathen people, so...
Well, I'll just put this one in the drawer here and... But all the other ones... They can go out here. There. Ain't they pretty?
Not as lovely as you, though.
No.
How you been there, Beth?
Bad.
Now.
Right bad, I have, right poorly.
You look wonderful.
Slowing down and tiring out.
Well, you look lovely.
Puny and sick and just not interested much no more. Running down.
No.
Running down. How are you?
Me? I'm good.
What are you doing here this time?
You know, same as usual. A guest instructor. See, the American Army flies me out. I take out a few of the young recruits, tell them a few stories from the bomb squad. Everyone has a sandwich and a bit of fruit. Then we blow up a mountain and I'm back home.
Ain't that dangerous, though?
Yeah, no, it seems as hours. We're miles away when it goes off. Okay, look at this. This is, my name is Ein. This is the Froggy Lasseur portable detonating device. Light, yet efficient. See, positive wire goes here. Negative, attached to the load. Just push this down, and... when there's mountain to worry about...
Bite out of one of my apples, then decides he don't want it no more, and then he throws it in here. Every day, he does it every day. Scolding him don't do no good because he's just a little half-wit, you know?
Yeah.
Good wine's that babies too. It's a waste, ain't it? Reverend David says I just ought to forgive him, but Reverend David just ain't the sweetest temperedest man on this green earth.
Reverend David?
You don't know Reverend David, do you?
No.
Normie's Catherine, do you?
I believe so.
Lord, the things that go on in this place lately are sick. Like, see, Aylard is Catherine's baby brother. And Catherine and Reverend David, they've engaged. They're staying here now.
Yes.
Separate rooms.
Of course.
And once they're married, they might buy the house.
What? This house?
Well, yes, they might.
Bad.
Oh, I know, it's hard for me to even say it sometimes.
But you've always had this house.
Oh, I know, but the winter caused a lot of damages, and I spent my last nickel fixing it. And now it seems that none of the regular summer folks want to come no more.
Well, why not?
Oh, they're scared it ain't safe no more.
Scared it ain't safe?
Oh, it's that Owen Mustard boy start all that talk. Mean old thing. Got himself made property inspector, telling him county, and now he says my foundation's rotten and I'm liable to get condemned. Come over here. You see that pile of bricks out there?
The car park, yeah.
Yeah, well, I bought it. But getting bricklayers at $20 an hour, I can't afford that, not unless we get some business around here.
Property's a bit cheaper if it's condemned, I suppose.
Yes, sir. Owen gets this place condemned and I can't even sell a house. Just the land under it. That's the law.
Well, he hasn't got interest in the place, has he?
Oh, no. He couldn't afford that little bush out there.
So these young people have money?
Well, yes, Catherine does. Her daddy was Sims Prepared Meat. I reckon you heard of him.
Have I done?
Well, yes, she's really well off now. She's the whole family. Her and Ella.
But, Beth, if you sell, where do you live?
Oh, I imagine it don't matter too much. If I can sell this old house, it won't be too long till me and you are together again.
Don't get off.
No, I've been thinking lately, and I've been adding things up.
No.
No, I haven't. And lately, I've been thinking one thing, the only thing that I regret, and don't you go telling nobody this.
No, of course not.
Is that I wish I would have traveled more like you done. Oh, is it sinful me to wish something like that, you reckon?
No.
Before you come along, I never knowed nobody outside of Tillman County. And then you told all them stories about them Arabs and them Greeks and such like, and laws, I lie awake at night wondering what them folks must be like, if them foreigners and all. And, well, it's too late now. You get older before you get around.
Well, you might be disappointed anyway.
Well, I wonder.
Yeah, look, take it from me. Your average foreigner, a bit on the dull side, quite boring. Dresses about like what we do, and of course, it's useless to say anything to him because he doesn't speak. He just. Hold on.
What is it, wrong with
me? Nothing. Look here, Beth.
Yes?
Well.
What is it?
Me just thinking.
What?
All right. There's this bloke. He's a mate of mine. I've brought him on.
Here?
Yeah, he's in my old room now. I'm going to take super care of him. Best everything, all right?
Well, yes.
There's just one little thing, and how should I put this? He mustn't be spoken to.
He mustn't when?
Ever.
Be spoken to?
No.
Why not?
Well,
wrong with him?
Oh, no, he's perfectly nice. He's a terrific fella. The thing is, he just doesn't speak English very well.
No?
No, in fact, not a word.
Oh.
Now, I can't say too much, mind you. I've got my orders. But if someone around here was looking to see a foreigner, a real one, perhaps they wouldn't have to look too far. That's right.
You mean to tell me that this man you brought, he was a...
As foreign as the day is long.
Oh, where's he from?
Where?
What country?
Well, I can't say any more. I've got my orders.
Oh, you mean to tell me he's here on some kind of special secret government work?
But I won't say no, and I won't say yes.
Oh, Lord. What's his name?
Charlie.
Charlie?
Well, his real name is, Charlie or something like that, but I call him Charlie.
Oh, and, He ain't a communist.
What? No, he's got a stack of credit cards in his wallet, that thick.
Oh, good.
Yes.
And none of us can talk to him?
No, it shames him, you see. He can't reply to what people say, and then he feels horrible. If you so much as say good morning to him, he walks by like this for days, and you don't want that.
Why, no, poor man.
Oh, he'll be no trouble. Regular meals, pot of tea once in a while.
Oh, my real foreigner.
Well, now don't expect Jojo the Jungle Boy. He's just a bloke.
Stale.
I'm off. I suppose I have to have a word with, Charlie before I go.
Oh, you speak his kind of talk?
You know, the odd phrase, hello, my hat is brown, where's the gent, that sort of thing.
Oh.
Oh, that'll be him now. Could you give him some tea, love?
Oh, yes. Love.
Charlie?
Not now for me. Just let me sit here for a while.
Well,
thank you.
That was real good, Charlie.
Go rum diddly move for a second, hey? Excuse for a moment, pet.
Oh, yes. Love.
What on earth?
Just listen. I've fixed it for you.
Why? What have you done?
I told you can't speak English.
What?
Well,
I told her I can't
speak English.
Why?
Remember what you said? I don't want to seem rude. Well, this way, you won't. You're waiting on hand and foot and our words spoken, right? What do you have to do? Nothing. What do you have to say? Nothing. And are they offended? No, they love you for it. Betty, you saw Betty. She already loves you. Why, you're picturesque.
Froggy, no.
What?
I can't.
Can't what?
Pretend.
You don't have to do anything. You sit there, you bring a bit of glamour to a sweet old lady's twilight years, and you bring yourself a bit of peace and quiet. You said you couldn't talk to anyone.
No, I can't. I was panicking.
You can?
Yes.
All right, well, you'll have to be the one to tell her.
Tell her what?
Well, that we've lied to her. That we've raised a little hope only to dash into the ground again.
We?
Well, I'm just glad I won't be here to see her little eyes well up with tears and watch her hacking away at her little wrists with a meat knife.
Frog.
What?
I can't. I'm sorry, I simply can't.
No, I suppose not. Daft idea, really. Well, when Betty comes back, just tell her I was joking, all right? She'll understand.
All right.
You be all right?
Yes, thank you.
Good. So long.
So long.
Hello, who's this? Oh, hello.
Hello. Oh, man, that's what we call a frog strangler out there. That is a storm. Say, you're not planning to go out in that, are you?
No, I'm not worried.
Oh, no, I wasn't worried either, not until I saw that old fella. He was gathering up their animals, two by two, putting them on a boat with him. Well, I don't know. Oh, hey, you must be Froggy the Servant.
That's right.
Betty's good friend. Well, I'm Dave, Dave Lee.
Lee, as in Robert E?
Yes, sir.
Any relation?
Yes, this.
Ah, he was a great strategist, Lee was.
Yeah, I know.
Oh, Reverend David.
Yeah, that's right.
Betty says you might buy the place.
Well, I do love this old lodge and all, but what we really hope is that Betty won't end up having a sale.
Well, you do right by her, I know.
Oh, yeah. I don't think we'd argue with whatever price Betty felt fair.
Right, well, give her my best. So long.
Well, it's good to meet you, sir.
Don't call me sir. I ain't no bloody officer.
Oh, hi, honey. Honey? Honey, if you really are, oh, come on.
Come here now.
No.
No, honey, come here. If you really are, then what do you think?
I don't know. I guess I'll go to Atlanta and find somebody.
Honey, no.
What do you mean, no?
Don't even
this
think about it.
This is me we're talking about. You think I'm going to walk down that aisle of ballooned up as big as a house in front of all my people? No, sir. No, I am not. No.
Well, listen, then we'll get married out of the way. Then we don't have to wait till November. We'll just do it now.
I don't want to do it now. It's planned for November. Oh, David, how did this happen?
Well, it's a miracle. That's what it is. That's what I think it is. Can't you see it that way? It must have been supposed to happen.
Well, I didn't suppose it to happen. You didn't suppose it to happen. You told me you could never have it.
Yeah, I know.
Well, then who supposed it to happen? The good Lord, I
know. Well, I think so, yeah.
Yeah, well, that's fine for him. He's not the one that's going to happen.
I know how you feel.
No, you don't.
Yes, I do. You feel trapped and wrong and not ready, but, honey, I love you. Now it looks like we're about to have a family. I say let's celebrate. I say let's just do it.
You really want to?
Yes.
Can I ask you something?
Anything you want.
Who the hell are you?
What?
Look!
Oh!
I mean, look at that! Take a look at the nerve of that! You were just sitting there this whole time!
No, honey, I'm sure that's
you. I can't believe it! Well, what's going on? I can't get over it. We're in here having this real personal conversation. Then we turn around and what do we see? This man sitting here just sitting there.
You want to talk to me, Owen?
I'll tear myself away.
Oh, I'll be right up to say goodnight.
Don't be too long.
Oh, don't worry.
Oh, okay, could you bring me a candle?
Candle?
Yeah, another candle. Mine's got shop.
I'll get you one, sure.
Bye.
Goodnight, honey.
You should go get a candle, don't you?
Well.
lonesome?
No. Place we
can
talk.
Oh, if you boys want to talk, you can do it right down here. You know the rules, no visitors upstairs. Don't you go bothering Charlie none.
Oh, we won't bother him.
All right, good night, David. Good night, David. And clock up, will you?
I will, thank you.
And don't believe everything you hear.
Oh, don't worry, baby.
Good night, Omen.
Good night.
Deaf, you just don't speak no English.
He don't speak.
That's right.
What's he doing here?
I don't know. I'm a friend of Betty's brought him over.
So he don't understand me, huh?
No.
Never a word.
Nope.
Well, is that right? A foreigner, huh, Charlie? We don't get so many of your kind around these parts. Why, I think the last time I saw a foreigner, he was wriggling at the end of my bayonet. Hey, dummy. You really don't understand me, huh?
No.
No, reckon not, because if he did, I'd know. I would. I'm real smart about some things, David. Like when people's play acting on me, I always catch them. I catch them every time. And when I do, I pour hot coke down their necks, like this. This is sort of fun. Say whatever the hell you want as long as you're smiling, can't you? Hey, Charlie, where's your mother? Where's your mother, huh? Underground someplace in some foreign graveyard the hell off somewhere? Probably pushing up palm trees or something. You ever wonder what she looks like now, Charlie? Huh, what your mother looks like? Probably not enough of her to spread on toast. Ain't you got nothing to say to that? Huh? Huh? Ain't you? You hear that? Oh, dump that, just beat it. Thank you, he says.
Yeah, well, that's all he knows.
Well, that's real good, Charlie. That's real good. You're gonna be some fun to have around here.
I'm gonna have some fun with you.
I really gotta get upstairs, now.
You do, huh?
Yeah, I won't, okay.
Talking sense to them Atlanta boys?
Oh, no, not yet, but I'm sure they'll come around.
All right. Well, got some news. Got me a little piece of paper in the mail today. You want to see?
What is it? Condemned?
Certified by the state office. This place was turned into a hell of a bargain.
Interesting.
Thought you might think so.
So how much could Betty ask for now?
Tops around 20,000.
Oh, that's a bargain, truly.
Need to buy the vehicle as soon as I make it. Be careful, she'll find herself another fire.
Oh, Betty's gonna wait till I have
fun. Oh, she gonna wait 6 months?
If need be.
Because remember, this ain't necessarily permanent, you know. That brickwork out there gets fixed, and you got yourself one little expensive property again.
Just brickwork.
That's right. That brickwork gets repaired, there's nothing I can do. Legally.
Okay, well, I don't think that we'll end up having to. Well, hey, Eller. How you doing? You know Owen? Owen Musser?
Hey.
What you been up to?
Where's Kath at?
Oh, she went upstairs.
Okay.
I tell you, Eller, you can do me a favor. You want to do me a favor?
Yeah.
All right, come on down. Now go into the kitchen and the refrigerator and get a carrot and bring it out to Kevin, will you?
A carrot?
Yeah, a carrot. You know what a carrot is, don't you?
Yeah, I know.
Oh, of course you do. Would you do that for me then?
Get her a carrot?
Yeah, that's right. I said I'd get one, but I can't get away right now.
All right.
That'd be a big favor. Thank you, Ellie.
Oh, Ellie. Poor boy.
What's the matter with him?
See, no one really knows. Owen, he's just, he needs a lot of patience. He's getting worse lately. His daddy dying and all. We think it's what it is. Sad thing.
So he can get none of his daddy's money, is he?
Oh, Eller? No, not likely.
You mean he might?
Well, theoretically, he's supposed to receive half the family money, but that's if Catherine should decide he's intelligent enough.
Intelligent enough, huh?
That's right.
That would seem too wacko, does it?
No.
House is full of dummies, ain't it?
Oh, that's good. You have any trouble?
No.
Oh, that's just fine. Can you take it up to Catherine, then? I'll be up in just a minute. Would you tell her?
All right.
All right. Thank you, Baylor.
Intelligent enough, huh? $100,000 or so? Probably spend it all on bubble gum or something.
I really should get upstairs. Thank you for your news. I'll take it from here.
You will.
I will.
You better.
Just have faith in me. The Lord will provide. If the Lord wishes Tillman County to have a good Christian club, then Tillman County shall have one.
Not.
You're not. Be careful.
Hey,
Oh, I'm just locking up, honey. Just trying to do me a favor. Here, here's a candle.
He said bring you a carrot.
Ellard, damn it, he did not.
Oh, honey, maybe I did.
Oh?
I was down here talking with Owen. Maybe I turned around and said carrot by accident.
Oh, David, it was a carrot instead of candle.
No, but it doesn't matter, though. Anyhow.
Lord, what a day.
Yeah, I know. How you doing now? You all right?
I guess.
All right, you go on up. I'll be right there.
Come on, Ellard.
I thought he said carrot.
I don't want to hear any more about it, Ellen.
Well, there's a good first lesson for you there, Charlie. You see, God helps those who help themselves.
Oh, do hurry. Hello, may I speak with Staff Sergeant, sir, please? Charlie Baker. No, it's not a code, it's my name. Hello, Froggy. Could you come get me, please? Froggy, you don't know what you've done. No, I mean by pretending not to speak English. Oh, well, I decided to after all. Oh, I overheard something I shouldn't have, and well, it seemed best. But Froggy, they don't leave me alone. No! The old woman does nothing but shout at me. The others talk about me as though I were a potted palm. That screaming girl and her poor adult brother, one thoroughly unpleasant chap, began saying the most awful things about my mother. Well, something to the effect that he doubted there were enough left of her to spread on toast. I don't know. No, of course I shan't tell mother, but still. And the minister, something very odd is going on with him, I think. I don't know. What is a Christian hunt club? No, nor I. Yes, I'll hold.
Where's Captain? Thank you.
No, that was the boy. I don't think he knows about me yet. Yes, he is rather hopeless, I'm afraid. Still, I can't help feeling that he's being...
Mitko asma vi Gallipoli mnie.
Oh, good morning, Charlie. Are you talking to Frog? Hey, Frog. Oh, hi. Charlie? Oh, he's he's just the sweetest thing in this whole wild world. Yes. What is he like for breakfast? Oh, no, it's no trouble at all. No, he makes me feel 20 years younger. Oh, yes, about 13. Oh, you done saved my life when you brought Charlie here, you did. Oh, Here he's back.
Ayler, you down there yet?
That boy. Carry on with your little talk.
He's low on school.
Low.
Frog? Yes, sorry. No, never mind. Don't send a jeep. No, it's only 2 days. But listen to me, Frog, and I need to say this. It's important.
Ayler, are you down?
Bosco.
Ayler, are you down there now?
Yes.
Are you on the ladder? Are you on the ladder?
I don't know.
What?
It's too dark.
Reach around and feel for that crossbar. You feel that?
I think so.
Okay, well now just slide it across and open up the door, but be careful when you're coming up not to walk up too high and tread on the door. Are you all right, Ellen?
Yeah.
All right, hand me the sauerkraut. Ellen, where's the jar I gave you? Oh, Ellard. Oh, are you all right?
Yeah.
All right, now do exactly as I say. Now close the door, slide the bar across, go to the barrel, fill the jar with the sauerkraut, then bring it with you when you come up.
All right.
Ellard! Come up the same way you went down, through the back door.
Have you seen David?
No, not this morning.
Can you see his car out there?
No, it's gone.
Shoot. Can't believe that without so much as a word again. I told him last night I'm supposed to be... Oh, hell, what am I talking to you for? Just going nuts, I guess. Nobody to talk to. I'm probably just ready for the funny farm. Shoot.
Thank you,
Ellard, have you seen David?
Nah, he went in the basement.
I didn't suppose he was in the basement. Off the damn poor people get is where he is, helping them skin hogs and make soap, looking after their damn souls. I just hope he won't mind having a wife he has to visit the insane asylum.
You want some breakfast?
No.
Catherine.
I don't want any breakfast. Now, don't ask me again. I don't.
All right, Ellen?
Huh?
Well, I know that Charlie wants eggs, but I know you don't like eggs, so what do you want?
Nothing either.
Ellen!
Well, Ellen, you have some breakfast. I'm supposed to be looking after you.
She's right. We have French toast, pancakes, what?
Eggs.
I thought you didn't like eggs.
French toast.
What? You can have eggs if you want them. I just thought you didn't want them. You want them?
Yeah.
Ellen, these questions aren't that hard. Anybody think you've been trying to make me mad deliberately?
Yes.
You are?
No.
All right, how do you like your eggs?
What?
How do you like your eggs?
They're real good, thank you.
Ellard!
What?
When I say, how do you like your eggs, I'm asking you, how do you want me to fix them?
Oh.
So, how do you like your eggs?
Fried?
All right.
Oh, boy. You two be... Excuse me. You two be up for a game of Scrabble later? I'm not busy making some exciting cookies or reading one of these delightful up-to-date magazines. Princess Diana has given birth to a baby boy. Her first. The child is as yet unnamed. When will she find a name for that baby? Yeah, shoot. When is that gal gonna find a name for that?
Buddy might be good.
What?
Buddy.
For what?
That little boy's name.
Yeah, Prince Buddy. Prince Buddy of England. Well, be fine. That's settled. I don't know what we're gonna do now. We name the prince. Go back to bed, I guess.
That's my favorite name. If I ever catch me that chipmunk, that's what he's gonna be. Buddy the chipmunk.
Ellen, you couldn't catch a chipmunk if all its legs were broken and it was glued to the palm of your hand.
Well, I wouldn't want to then.
Well, here's your eggs, and juice and grits is on its way. Come on. I don't mind. Right here. Yes. Oh, you want some coffee, honey? Or?
No.
Toast?
No.
Oh, just asking. What are you so edgy about today?
I am not edgy.
Oh, can't ask questions in my own home.
Not to me, you can't know. You want to ask questions? Ask Ella's questions. Don't ask me, all right?
How do you like your eggs?
Fried.
I guess I'll go walk down by the lake. Some more. Katrina. Well, is she gonna? From here said that Charlie doesn't drink any coffee, but if you want some, you wasn't up last night, were you? Oh, this here's Charlie. He's a foreign fella. Doesn't speak any English, even hardly when you say it real loud. So don't go and try to talk to him, you understand?
He doesn't.
No, he doesn't speak any English. He's a foreigner. I don't reckon you've ever seen any foreigners before.
No.
Well, foreigners, they're just like regular blokes.
Uh-huh.
Get used to all the different kind of strange ways, and they're talking all, I know I have. Everything all right, Charlie? There, you see? He didn't understand me, but he kind of understood me, because we have this kind of extracurricular communication going, him and I.
Carly.
So behave yourself, and don't pay Charlie no mind.
I will.
All right. Oh, Aylard! What do you call yourself doing?
I don't know.
Oh, Charlie, no, put it back on. Why'd you have that glass on your head?
It was just something we were doing.
Oh, now, you know better than to tell me that. See, if Charlie wants to... No, Charlie, leave it on. See, if Charlie wants to put a glass on his head, that's just something that they do in his country. Evidently, they all wear glasses on their heads at breakfast time. Don't let me catch you doing it. Makes you look like you're making fun of him, you hear?
Yes.
What was that, what you was trying to do? Was you trying to be funny?
No.
All right. All right.
I know. It's all right. Take it. You can take it down now. You're copying me? Why in the world? Don't tell me you've ever seen a knife before. Knife. That is a knife. Use it to cut things. Cut things. Well, like a ham. If we had a ham, or like bacon or something. I can't believe you don't. Or butter. If we had some butter, you could use it to like spread it on. You don't really need it. No, you don't need it. Put it down. Bad. Yeah, now that's your spoon. Use that to put the sugar in your coffee. We had some sugar here, or we had some coffee. Phew, I don't really know why we got all these things. But your fork, man, I wish somebody else would help you with that, because, well, I don't know anything. But I'd say your fork is the main thing you'd use, because you got your eggs, and you got your grits, and you eat them with a fork, just like we've been doing. Can you say fork? Fork. 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 Two parts. Fork.
Fork.
Right. Now put them together. Fork.
Fork.
Good. That was great. Yeah, that was great.
Fork.
That's right. Now let's see. Eggs.
Eggs.
Yep, that's good.
Eggs.
That's right. Let's see. Grits.
Grease.
Grits. It's called hominy grits, really. That's fine. Grits is fine for now. Just grits.
Grits.
That's right. Let's see, what else do we have here? Plate.
Plate.
Sofa.
Sofa.
Stove.
Stove.
Rug.
Rug.
Lamp.
Lamp.
Bottle.
Bottle.
Glass.
Glass.
Well, that's all the important stuff in here. You wanna, what do you wanna do now? We could go outside, check out, you know, all the trees and stuff. We don't have to, but we could. Or, yeah, no, let's just stay in here. Rest up. And then we'll go outside and check out all the trees and all directly. Because you will. That's, those are the things you want to know. Because if you ever want to ask someone, like, where a tree is or something, that's the kind of stuff you want to know. But like cars or, like, chipmunks or things and all. You know, all that outdoorsy stuff. Yeah. Or you know what I could do? I could go outside and bring some stuff in. I just might do that. Well, since that way, we'd have everything we want right in here, where we want it, but we wouldn't have to go outside. All right, I'm gonna go. You wait here, then I'll be right back. No, you wait here. Stay. All right.
So where are you going?
Miss Meeks, I'll have to talk right now, but I'm just real busy.
Laws. Are you done with your breakfast? You took off your little head last thing, so I reckon you must. Oh, they mean you've done it. It must. Oh, well, that they mean you enjoyed it? It does. Oh. Oh, I don't think I caught all that. Was you saying somehow you looking forward to more of my cooking? And how you're hoping that I'm going to make some chicken? Why, Charlie, you're in luck, because you know what we're having this very night? That's right, chicken! Oh, laws and laws. I ain't it serious how I can just kind of read your brain thoughts coming out. I had a pet skunk once, too, and I always know just what he was thinking. He the same kind of way of looking at me as you do and all. Yes, sir, you're just like him. You're hoping I'm gonna play you some harmonica music? Why, how'd you know I used to play one of those? Why, well, that was 30 years ago. Oh, wait right here.
Oh, Mary, if only you could see.
Burn the place down. Now that's a switch.
Yeah, vile most of the time.
Yeah, he is. He's so sweet, and he does for people, and he's so patient. And you get with him a while, and you realize you spent your whole life being selfish and silly, doing dumb things like this. Yeah, I was one of these little cute patooties back a year ago. Yeah, what a year, Lord. Dressing up, flouncing around, bopping all over on my daddy's plane, sipping at drinks in revolving restaurants. Dumb, stupid, useless, mindless bullshit! I miss it. I do. I don't think I was cut out to be a decent person, you know? Some people are just meant to be a waste of food, and I think I'm one of them. I'm good at it. And a year from now, what? I'm gonna be a mother, probably own this house. Preacher's wife, hold the damn phone a minute. How would all this happen? You tell me that. Oh, Charlie. I guess I just wish things didn't change quite so fast. But they do. They surely do. You got some nice eyes, you know that. You're probably real nice. You're a good listener. You are. Say thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.
Hey. Thank you. Here, this ought to hold us for a while. Oh, Ken, could you scoot over? I thought of some other things we could do. We could look at pictures and stuff in books. Yeah, it's not quite as good, but just about.
Emma, what are you doing?
We're working on some words. Charlie wanted us to.
Oh.
I'll show you a look. You ready, Charlie? What's this? Sofa. That's right. And what's that? Stova.
Well, Ellen.
And what's this here? Rug. That's good.
Well, Ellen, I declare.
And what's that right there? Ends with um. Lamb, that's right.
You taught him to say all these words?
Yeah.
Well, I found it. He's burying some Mr. Meek's old things in him. What's going on in here?
Ellard's teaching Charlie.
He is?
All right, Charlie, now here are some new ones. Rock, rock. Bush, bush.
Well, my land.
Brick, brick.
Oh, Charlie seemed to want to hear some harmonica music, so I said...
You play that?
Well, used to could, but I better go practice somewhere.
My God, a dangerous crowd.
Oh, where are you off to?
Just scaring up breakfast.
You are?
Yeah.
You all right?
Yes, ma'am.
Walk.
All right now, Charlie. What I'm going to do, I'm going to take all these things we just learned, and I'm going to mix them up, all right? Now, no food. Yeah, no mess. I was hoping to clean up after a fire down there.
A fire?
Yeah, just down the road. No one heard though.
That's good.
Yeah, but I'm gonna be gone for a couple of days. Oh well, now what's this?
Come on, Ethan. We're liable to disturb Ellen.
What's he doing?
English lesson.
English? All right, now Charlie, hands down. Down. All right, now. What's this?
Brick.
That's right. And what's this?
Bush.
Real good.
Well, yeah.
Rock. Rock, that's right, rock. All right, let's do some new ones. Jar. Charlie. Jar.
Jar.
Nail.
Nail.
Board.
Board.
Leaf.
Leaf.
All right, now together. Jar. Nail.
Board.
Leaf.
Back house lights, please. Those first. And 10 minutes. And now you can hit the satellites.
Mm-hmm.
cop squad, do your thing. Should I put him on the program, or?
No, I wouldn't. He's come to like three rehearsals, so if he shows up, great, if not.
Okay.
Hey, Jacob?
Yeah?
Can we get Mike?
Oh, yeah, you guys are gonna be playing.
Yeah, we are.
Jesus. Yeah, gotcha.
It's not good, because the band fell apart.
I can play the flute. Do you guys want me to?
Yeah, you want to sing too?
Sure.
You want to sing? Right. You can join us to sing. We'd be more than happy to.
I don't know the song. Does that matter?
Not really.
Thank you.
that's 6 minutes and 49 seconds.
Yeah, I figured she probably need more.
Can we do more?
Yeah.
Okay, are we gonna make this one longer? We
can make it longer if we sing every chorus.
Okay. Let's hit those backlights, Daisy.
Alright, yeah, that would probably be a lot longer. And then there's one for song too.
Alright. Where's everybody?
There's no telling.
I still think we gotta do this in the van.
No, let's just see what we got.
Alright. Now this is all we got left, I think. That was one bad fire.
Yep.
Well, if he's lucky to get the guns out of them rear carbines and such. Suppose that book of yours don't say nothing about rear carbines,
no,
does it?
Not much.
It's a mystery to me how you plan to take over this place without raising a little hell.
Don't worry about it.
Well, cause you remember you You was heading up this operation for just one reason. Now, you done made us a lot of promises. So if you don't come up with some right quick, I'm gonna work the money. I mean money. We need ourselves some money, and we need ourselves a building. And I mean,
I'm sure we'll have it when this place is condemned. As long as those new bricks don't get used, it stays. I still cannot just take this place. Just take it.
Oh, listen.
You and I have got such an opportunity here. The whole Georgia Empire, what's left of it, is all out there in the van. The uniforms, the hardware, all of it. We're in such a position, I swear. If you can keep a secret this time tomorrow, I expect to be a happily married homeowner.
What?
True, quietly, legally. See, there's no reason to get gun happy, and there's no need to arouse the law until we are the law.
Man, if it weren't for that money.
I know, just think of the money and calm yourself. Let's get this over.
All right. Papers?
Good, records, addresses. Oh, we need these. Oh, praise God.
Boy, happy. Looky here. Do I like me some dynamite?
Wait. Did we just drive up this mountain with a box of dynamite?
Don't you worry. These babies won't go off without a charge. These is good little babies.
All right, just put it back. Back in the van. Bennett goes over to this house with a toothbrush, and I don't want to have to explain dynamite.
All right. Say, why'd you tell me he was getting married tomorrow?
I thought you was getting married in November. No, Catherine and I just couldn't wait till November.
Oh, no?
No. Just too much in love.
13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 20.
Good, now how many stairs?
20.
That's right, and how many fingers?
6.
Real good. Now, here's a tricky one. How many little pieces of sand? A zillion.
Zillion?
Yeah, when there's lots of something, you can just say a zillion.
Zillion.
That's right.
I was hoping you boys would come back. Well, here's your dinner. Oh, and grits is on its way.
Don't you rush now.
Oh, I am.
You're doing real good, though, for this 2 days' work.
Thank you. I am happy.
Good. Now, how many chairs?
3 chairs.
That's right. And how many forks?
4 forks.
And how many pieces of chicken?
4 chickens.
That's right.
How many grits?
A zillion.
What?
Nothing.
Oh, hey, dinner time, huh? Where have y'all been?
The courthouse, again.
Hot times until in Georgia. Go down and watch them build a new courthouse.
Yeah, Charlie Wan is too.
How are they coming with it?
Real good. They let me help out today.
Oh my goodness, Ellard, they did?
Yeah, they said I was real. You know, real good.
Yes, they say good.
Well, heavens, Ellard. Well, I thought they would. You want some coffee, honey?
No, I was just going to drive Charlie into taking a stroll before dark.
Oh, another one of your strolls, huh?
Yeah, I tell Charlie all of my problems, and he just listens and nods, you know? No one can keep a secret like Charlie can.
Oh, I think he knows more than he's letting on.
Lord, I hope not. I'd be so embarrassed.
Well, Charlie's remarkable anyhow. I know that much.
Oh, yes, ma'am. No doubt about it. Truly remarkable. Hmm?
Remarkable.
Remarkable.
Good!
Oh, Rose! Lovey!
What are you doing here?
Oh, you know, I just couldn't stay away from you. Your flashing eyes and your perky little nose.
Hey, stop.
Oh, I'll try. Hello?
Oh, this is Karen.
Ah, yes.
Hello. And Ellard.
Hey, that'd be nice.
This here's Charlie's friend that brought him here.
That's right. Charlie, how's that going then?
Just rang in, sir. Couldn't be better. Everything's fine.
Really?
Yes, indeed.
But I thought...
Oh, what was Charlie around? You just sort of forget about the bad thing.
You do?
Oh, yes, he was playing wrong about Charlie. He said that Charlie was going to be all quiet-like and regular and boring.
What?
No.
Yes, sir. That's what he said. Do you believe it? Why, not to us, he ain't. Why, I don't reckon a moment goes by with Charlie saying something or doing something real cute and strange. Like, wearing his little headless breakers.
Wearing his little what?
Why, Charlie ain't born at all. Why, he's simply...
Remarkable.
Remarkable, yes.
Well, I thought I'd be a bit shy here. And on his home country, of course, he's quite the raconteur.
The what?
Ah, you know, jokes, amusing stories. Yes, quite the entertainer back home, they tell me.
Oh, tell one.
Huh?
Oh, tell one of your... I'll make him tell one of his stories.
Oh, no, I didn't mean...
Oh, please, come on, ask him.
Well...
Oh, you hear that, everybody? Charlie's gonna tell one of his favorite stories. This is a chance of a lifetime. Go on.
Charlie... Is this all right? I mean, Poco Dum Funo Storos.
Mirduski omni polishnia mirlo aramsni bro o o pino.
Smitna, 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 smitna.
To tu perznosnia datski marla. Oh, beautski datski. Perstama sa baha raha. Hai. Charlie, that was real good.
Thank you.
And I practically understood all of it, I think. That's funny how the two I thought. That part about the tractor, that was real clear to me.
Tractor?
Yeah, wasn't there somebody at a tractor riding around? Or
I don't know.
Tractor?
Yeah.
No.
No, Betty, I didn't think so. There wasn't any tractor in the story.
No, story is about big machine to cut ground. Big, Charlie, that is. That's a tractor.
Oh?
Yes.
Oh, tractor.
Yes.
Yes, yes. Story is about tractor.
Oh.
Yes.
I thought I was
going to say it. Oh, my goodness.
Yes, yes. I am sorry.
No, no, no.
No, don't be sorry.
I am bad.
No. No, not Charlie.
No, now don't you even say that.
No, Charlie.
That was a wonderful story.
Charlie.
It was wonderful. You are wonderful, you.
Yes.
No.
Yeah, yes, I are. Yes, you are.
Oh, Charlie.
Oh, look at him.
My goodness.
Oh, so sweet.
I'm going to be sick in a minute.
What?
Nothing. He's picked up a bit of English, I see.
Oh, yes, he's been good hands.
Yes, last night I learned to read.
To read?
To read books.
Ah.
Yes,
and how long did it take you to teach him to read?
About an hour.
1 hour, right?
Yeah. Yes, I show you.
Well, how did I miss this?
Here, you help.
Okay.
Shall I compare thee to a summer's day? Thou art more lovely.
And more temperate. Yes?
Yeah, that's right.
Edward, you taught him all that in just an hour?
Yeah.
I can't believe that.
Me neither. Remember how long it took me to learn to read? About 3 years.
But what do you think accounts for the difference?
I don't know. I guess he just had a better teacher.
Yes, remarkable.
Yeah, I guess so. Remarkable. Y'all are right. Pretty soon I'm gonna have to stop talking to you, Charlie.
Stop. Talk.
Well, if you really know what I'm saying, I can't tell you all my secrets, can I?
Hey, stop. Learn.
No, Charlie, you go on and learn. Maybe I'll just tell you all my secrets anyway.
Yes?
We'll see.
Yes?
We'll see.
What mean, we'll see?
Oh, it means yes.
We'll see mean yes.
This time, it means yes.
In my country, yes is gok. Gok. Gok.
How do you say no?
Bleat.
Bleat.
Gok.
Uh-huh.
You would like some?
Gok. You?
We'll see.
Oh, well. Ain't this nice?
Froggy, ain't this nice?
Yes, very nice. Getting away with bloody murder is what it is.
What?
Nothing. I just feel a bit dull, that's all.
Well, Frog, you can't help it if you ain't a foreigner.
No, I suppose not.
Plus, we gotta make the most of Charlie. He's leaving us tomorrow.
But if we can get to go, yeah.
La la, blasny blasny.
Yeah, blasny blasny, right.
What's that mean?
What? Blasny blasny. Well, I think it means enjoy it while you've got it. Am I right, Charlie?
No. Blasny blasny, it means ain't this nice.
Yes, well, not far wrong, was I? I'd love to stay longer, but I think I'd go mad if I did. So. Love, I'll be back tomorrow. Charlie, Gomo Rim Jambo, eh?
Gomo Rim Jambo? I swallow little fishies?
Oh, you little!
Oh, look, it's David.
David? Well, about time. What's he doing with that van?
Selling vegetables, maybe, from it.
What?
Sometimes people sell vegetables from the back of those.
Well, if you say so, then that might be right.
Yeah.
Yeah, well, he's not gonna see me like this. You two keep him out there until I get back down.
All right. Nice to meet you, Froggy.
Right.
I'm sorry, something must have come over me.
Yeah, you made me look like a blatant idiot.
I know, I... Well, I did, didn't I?
Yeah,
I really did. And you know what? It wasn't that difficult.
Oh.
Nothing to it, really. That gives me an idea.
Oh, yeah? Well, I've got an idea!
Froggy, I'm sorry, I didn't mean to. If only I could tell you what an adventure I've been having. I haven't quite sorted it out myself yet, but... Froggy, I think I'm acquiring a personality.
Oh?
Yes, people around here just seem to hand it to me, piece by piece, as they walk into the room. You see? You just did it too. Suddenly, I'm a raconteur. And suddenly, I'm Catherine's confessor, and Ella's prize pupil, and Betty's pet skunk.
What?
And look, look, reading Shakespeare. Because of me, you see, we, all of us, we're becoming, we're making one another complete and alive and, oh, I can't explain myself, but, oh, I shall miss them. I shall miss them terribly.
Well, I suppose it's all right then. I'm late.
Frog, thank you. Thank you for making me a foreigner.
You're a bit like Dr. Frankenstein. Never mind. Have yourself a lark.
Frankenstein. Yes.
Hey, dumb. Still here, huh? Having a nice time? Oh, I bet you are. Soaking around. playing like you're one of us. Well, I tell you one thing, dummy boy, you enjoy it now. Cause I get to be county sheriff around here and I got that invisible empire to back me up. Oh man, there ain't gonna be none of you left in this country. Foreigners, all you dummy boys, black boys, Jew boys. Yeah, we're gonna clean up this country by and by. And you know where it's gonna start? Right here. That's right. This is going to be the most important spot in the U.S. of A. Come the next couple years. It is. But you ain't going to see it, though. No, sir. We're going to ride y'all out of here any way we can. Plane, boat, yeah. We can afford it, too. We got a lot of money coming in real soon. You don't hope? I hope some of you fight back. I sure hope you do. Because I want to find out what you got for blood. Are you happy? Hey, you're talking.
Hello, 1, 2, 3. I am happy. Goodbye.
Oh.
1, 2, 3, G.I. Big shot, you see the 1, 2, 3, Donna upside down, okay? Hello? Hello? Big bang, dizzy dally, flip flop, juggernaut, big bang theory.
What the hell are you talking about, Jeffrey?
Hello, 1, 2, 3, I am happy. Goodbye.
I look through your bones.
Say what?
Yes, me see. Moon get big, you sleep. Sleep.
Out! Out! All you skin! Bye bye!
I look through your bones.
Wait, what are you talking about, mister?
Round and round and in the town. Gonna look into your bones when the bees come down.
No! 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 Somebody in here! Get in here! Somebody in my head! What's the matter, Owen? This fellow's become crazy! Wait, he is talking weird!
Well, he doesn't speak English.
No, he don't. Wait and learn some.
What'd he say?
I don't know, some kind of weird zombie talk.
Oh, like what?
I don't know, like the bees coming down.
Bees?
Yeah, the bees coming down and see through bones and 1, 2, 3 and all.
Well, that doesn't sound too bad.
Not to you, it don't. It was the same about to you. Man, you should have seen him. His eyes got all funny. There was some kind of rays coming out of them. I seen him. Some kind of weird hoodoo man. That's what I think he is.
Simmer down now, Owen. He seems all right to me.
Well, he ain't.
Charlie's nice. What's he done about bees?
Oh, yeah. Well, bees come down. That's what he said. I heard him. Bees come down.
Well, maybe he did, but still.
Aw. Please, calm down.
Please calm down. That's what he was trying to say, Owen. Not bees come down. I think that's good advice, too.
I know it was something like that.
He said bees come down.
Oh, bees come down don't make no sense.
I know that. That's what's bringing it to your attention.
All right, Owen.
Oh, don't talk to me with that. All right, Owen. Like I'm some kind of dumb halfway kid or something.
All right.
Well, look at who's here. The young Reverend David Marshallee is out living free. Decided to make an appearance, didn't he, after being gone for a whole day?
Oh, I've been gone for 2 days.
Oh. And he brought home a pretty little green van, too.
Oh, that's right. The company that burned down, you know, in Atlanta, they were so grateful to me and Owen for our service that they loaned me their Volkswagen van for my ministry until they rebuilt it. Isn't that something?
Very nice.
Yeah, it's a much-needed gift, I'll tell you that. Straight out of the ashes. Oh, praise God.
Eller figured he was going to sell vegetables from it.
Yeah, well, that's Eller.
Hey, El.
Hey.
Oh, what Eller here has been teaching Charlie English.
Oh, well, did you continue with that? That's fine.
Yeah.
Teaching him various words and so on, were you?
Yeah.
That's good. That's just fine. He, Ellard, teach you.
Indubitably. Yes?
That's right.
Ellard?
He teach, he has taught me many new words, considering it has only been 2 days.
Well, Ellard, that is amazing!
Tomorrow, we learn prepositional phrases, yes?
Well, we might, yeah.
I can't believe this. David, can you believe all
no,
this?
It is hard to believe, isn't it?
You two, first that courthouse business and now this?
Sorry, what?
Oh, Charlie's been taking Eller down to watch him build a new courthouse. And you know what? They've got Eller learning how to lay bricks.
What?
Yeah, I guess he's getting compliments from the workers and everything.
Yes.
Yeah, all these achievements. I think you're out of a party or something.
Yeah, surprise party, oh, maybe.
Or you know what? I know what. Listen, y'all. Ellen, do you know what I'm gonna do? By God, I'm gonna give you your inheritance.
Catherine!
I am! Daddy said if I ever thought you were smart enough to handle it, I was to give you half the family money. $112,000.
Golly.
Just stand there, why don't you?
Wow, that's wonderful, honey. I tell you what, even better, right after we get married, we could have a big celebration. We could present him the check together.
All right.
Good.
We've got Charlie to thank, really.
Oh, yes, Charlie. I would like to find out more about you. Tell me.
Gawk?
Sorry, what?
Gawk?
Means yes.
Oh, I see. Gawk?
Gawk. And blit is no.
Blit?
Gawk.
Oh, and Charlie, where is it that you're from?
From?
Yes, what do you call your home?
Totally house.
No. I mean, where do you live?
Where do you live at? Where do I live at? Ah, I show you. Do you have glove?
Glove?
Glove. Glove of world.
Oh, no, I don't believe we do, but we might have an atlas or something. Betty?
I have a map, but it's just a Georgia.
Oh, well.
Oh, it's good. It's good. Here, I show you. Yeah, you hold.
Oh, come on, Owen. Just hold the map, all right?
So, you leave here?
Yes.
So, I leave... Go. Go. Go! Out! Out! Go!
Back in, Owen.
My home.
Oh, looks like a nice place to live.
What the hell was I doing out there?
Oh, I don't know. Y'all in here looking at Charlie's home.
Never mind, Owen.
Never mind!
I was trying to find out some details about Charlie, but apparently it's going to be difficult.
Hello.
Charlie, what language do you speak?
What language?
Do you speak?
Do I speak?
Yes.
Yes, hello.
No. Your tongue. What name do you have for your tongue?
Floppy.
Floppy.
Yes, Floppy the tongue.
What name you have for your tongue?
Floppy.
Yeah. Remarkable, same as mine.
David, why don't you Ellen help you?
Yeah. All right. He wants to know about your kind of talk.
My kind of talk? Gawk? Bleep? Yes?
Yeah.
Yes. I teach.
What?
I teach to you.
No, No, that's not what I was trying
no,
to
say. No, my kind of talk bad.
What?
Oh, I am bad.
Oh, Charlie. Oh. David, for fourth sake.
Oh, what?
Hurt his feelings.
I hurt his feelings?
Yes.
What about me? What about my feelings?
David.
I'm serious.
Just try to get along with him, that's all.
I tried to get along with him, didn't I? What did I find out? His tongue's name is Floppy and he lives in the air.
David.
It's a little frustrating. Come on, won't you grant me that?
No, it's not. You have to be patient.
Patient. You're telling me to be patient.
David.
Who the hell are you to tell?
I've never seen you like this.
Maybe it's just a phase.
All right, what do you want? You want me to sit here and learn some words from this man?
Well, yes. Look at him. He really just wants to give us something. Can't you see that?
Yes. I really want to give it to you.
All right.
I teach now?
Yes. Why don't you teach me something?
Don't that just cut it, do whatever she tells me to do, I reckon. Well, I reckon if she asked
Owen, we can discuss this later.
There ain't gonna be nothing to discuss. Now I want to go into town and tell my friends you've been shining up to foreigners.
Owen, maybe if you think about this, you'd realize why I'm doing it.
I can see why.
Who cares, David? Let him go.
No, honey. Owen is one of God's children, too, and I think he might profit from a lesson as much as any of us. Owen, I think you should stay, and I think you should join me in this.
I ain't sitting here talking no damn hoodoo talk.
Owen, you must learn to be meek, otherwise you may never inherit the earth.
I'm not sure what you just did.
I just doubled the size of Charlie's class, honey.
All right, I teach now.
All of us?
Or say, gok bleat.
Gok bleat.
You say, gok. Gok.
Come on, Owen. It's not gonna hurt you. We're all sharing things, Harry.
Yes, we share.
Talking about it all, do you?
Oh.
Oh, you didn't know what you were getting us to do with that little language lesson of yours.
I.
Well, you're not to blame. You were just being yourself. But we've got to... I promised we wouldn't call the police. Who else? Who do people call? The army?
The army.
Or the Marines?
Froggy.
Yeah, all right, let's call Froggy. I doubt he's back yet. But who else? Any neighbors or old friends?
Trying to imagine all who ain't dead.
Yeah.
We get Fred Marvindale or Old Man Reed or...
Maybe we just ought to call the police.
Oh, is it Perky Pile? He come up, but he's missing both arms.
Let's call the police.
Hello? Hello?
Answering machine. Great. Come on. Yeah, this is Catherine Sims up at Betty's. Listen, Froggy, we might be in trouble. There might be some men on their way up here with guns. I don't think they like foreigners too well. If you could just, I don't know, bring anything you can. If you see a mean-looking fella driving a green van, that's Owen Musser. Kick a hole in his tire or something, will ya? We're calling the cops. There's probably nothing to... Hello? Hello? We've been cut off.
Oh, let me see.
Ellen, try the lights. Hello? Betty, they've cut our electricity off.
What?
They've cut the electricity off down the road or somewhere. No, that scares me.
Oh, that don't sound too right, don't it?
We're not schooling now. It's gonna be dark soon.
Oh, they better not. They come up tearing away this house and trying to scare Charlie.
David's down there, I know, but... Listen, should we have to defend ourselves? What have we got?
Oh, well, we don't have any guns. Mr. Meeks wouldn't let me keep any in the house. He said he had enough of them in war, so...
Ellen, help us think.
Me?
I just gave you $100,000 for being smart. You're the highest paid mom you've got now. Think of something.
This could work.
Yeah, all right.
Oh, Charlie, I plumb forgot we had you here.
Huh?
You come up with a plan. You've been all over the world. You've all the mysterious ways of doing things and all that.
You can think of something.
Any idea you have, Charlie, even a stupid one at this point.
Stupid idea. Stupid idea.
It doesn't have to be stupid.
Oh, he is an idea. I can always tell.
If you do, if you have any kind of idea, please tell us.
Listen, I'm not really...
Charlie? What are you thinking? Charlie?
Sheets?
What?
Backlights. Devil.
Open up his face and he said, I'll start the show and fire ruthless fingertips and rock.
sounded something like this.
So long ago.
Only 2 days, Charlie, that's all. Are you married or anything?
Yes.
What's her name?
Mavra.
Mavra, that's pretty.
Yes. She is ill.
Oh, I'm sorry. Do you love her a lot?
Yes.
And what all do you do together? Do you take walks together?
Yes. Sometimes we take walks apart.
Uh-huh. Do you have lots of friends?
Yes. She have 23.
23?
Any sign of company?
No.
Oh, well, I unscrewed all the light bulbs upstairs just like Charlie said, so even if the electricity comes back on, it'll be dark as pitch up there.
Well, I'm hoping the danger's past.
Oh, don't tell Ellard that. He wants to try out Charlie's plan.
Now, did we lock that front door?
I'll get it.
Just me.
I'm still the Jeffy, I guess.
I thought they'd meet up again if you want to try it once more.
No, why don't we just stay here a while, okay?
All right, I think we got it anyhow.
All right, now think. If they did come up here, what's the worst that could happen?
They could kill us, and they could chop us up into little pieces and hang us from trees.
You're thinking too much, Ellard.
That's what I get paid for.
Look at this commando group. We got, a foreigner, an ex-deb, an hassle lady, and a wealthy bricklaying English teacher. I don't see how we could lose to you. Oh, and a croquet mallet. Yeah, I'm entirely stupid.
Also, we have stupid plan.
That's right, stupid plan, stupid croquet mallet. We're set.
What's wrong with my croquet mallet?
Oh, nothing.
I thought it was good.
Well, it sure gave us a chance to find out how brave we all are.
Yes.
Now, Betty, my guess would be that... What is it, hon? I think I saw a headlight through the trees. Yup.
Well, maybe it's Frog or Daisy, or...
Nope. Are we locked up? We can do that anyways.
I'll get it.
Is it them?
Yeah, it's them. I can see their damn torches. They'll be here in no time. There's the van.
Oh, y'all better get upstairs.
Yeah, come on, Ellard.
I...
Don't think about it, El. Come on.
I...
If we're gonna do this, El, come on.
What's wrong, Ellard?
stupid, they're gonna...
Don't think about it, Elf. You have any choice. Let's go. I can't get him to.
This, it's croquet mallet. In my country, it's great symbol of freedom.
Huh?
Yes, we have king. Great, famous...
Charlie?
Famous warrior. Warrior king. Very brave. Many battles he win with croquet mallet.
What?
Always fight with croquet mallet. Here, hold. Ah, the same. You look like him.
The king?
Yes, the king. King Buddy.
King Buddy?
Yes.
Charlie?
Yatskavnia Pridotsk. Yatskavnia Stratnia Balni Barbi Atrashi Hon. Stern Undran Krasni. La Guerra Civil. Solamente le enfants du paradis.
What's that mean?
It means separately. We are all single people, but together we are as four.
I think so too.
Let's go get it.
King Buddy, Charlie,
go,
how
go.
Do you know?
Are you the owner of this house?
You know I am.
Are you prepared to stand this knot before the holy tribunal of the invisible empire?
Oh, and I am.
Are you, woman, prepared to stand this knot before the holy tribunal of the invisible empire? I'm giving you your last chance to answer. Is this here the foreign man that you've been harboring up there? Are you aware of your crimes against our people for which you stand liable and accused? Speak!
Charlie, I done nothing wrong with you, no!
Alright, you murderer. This is man we bombs. Give me that walkie talk. Alright, Billy boy, cut the lights back up. This here's the invisible empire. Take a good look, Charlie boy, because we're gonna be taking care of you for a while. That's right. We're going to be taking Charlie Boy off your hands. Treat him real nice, too, on account that he's our hostage. Now, what are the rest of y'all going to do? Y'all are going to just disappear. Going to be escorted that highway there. Going to take the first trailway bus out here. And nobody's going to ever see you again. Because if we do, Charlie Boy is going to find out what his hands look like. You see, this is the Klan. You had a mess with the Klan. Say, where's the girl and the kid brother at? Well, search the damn house. Come on now, let's get everybody down here. Well, pretty little lady, take one last good look at the house. Because it's going to be a bag of property this time tomorrow. Free for the taking. Headquarters, GHQ for White America. We got everything we need out there in that van. All we got to do is go in.
Sorry!
Well, hey there, party. What you hiding on stuff there?
Charlie!
Where's your kid brother at?
They got both of us. It was so dark. Ellen, they're tying them up right now. I'm sorry. No, Camper, don't blame yourself. We tried. We all tried.
All right, then. Well, come on, monkey boy. How about you get up on the table and do us a little monkey dance? Come on, man.
Me, I, who have lain in wait, lo, these many centuries for such a night as this.
What?
I, child of Hrothgar and of Moloch, I, whom the old ones have given a sup, to rise above the forest mold and smite thee, Klaatu Barada Itu.
No, you cut that out. I'm warning you.
A thousand serpents in my mouth, and each one squeals with pleasure.
You cut that damn booby talker. Somebody's gonna get hurt.
Dance near at me, you puny earthling.
fine.
Oh, you did a good crow.
I know.
Oh, that was real good. That even gave me the shivers. My God, Charlie, it worked. It really worked. Oh, are there any more of them folks upstairs?
Just that one we conked on the head. I took these off and he was still asleep.
Oh, was he hurt by Ada?
I don't know. It was too dark.
Oh, we better go check on him before you, David?
Where'd they go?
David, what in the world?
Where'd they go? What's happened?
Who? The clan? You scared them all off.
You? No, no, you couldn't have.
Yeah, we did. It wasn't that hard.
You! That's it then, that's the end!
David?
Oh, I was so close, it was in my hands, Kathy, it's all about to happen.
What?
We just needed the money.
The money? What are you talking about?
I'm talking about a new nation, Catherine. A white Christian nation. With these hands I was bringing about. With these hands! You and I, we were going to be at the forefront of the most powerful Christian force on earth.
The clan?
Yes, the clan. The invisible empire. Oh, don't look at me like that. It's true. We were going to wipe this nation clean of people like him.
David!
Foreigners, Jews, Catholics!
No! Stop it! What are you talking about? Nobody's like him. Nobody's like anybody.
Open your eyes, Catherine. They're taking it.
The money.
What?
The money. You said the money.
Catherine.
Mama. That's why you wanted to marry.
No.
You were going to finance the clan with my money.
No, Catherine. I loved you.
Then why did you tell me? Why did you tell me about this thing you've been doing?
I...
Why?
I wanted it to be a surprise!
Get out of here, David.
Fine. But I want you to remember this day when some foreigner is trying to take his bread up.
What? Is that your van outside?
My... Hold the van! Oh, praise God, they've left me in my van! I can do it alone, I can start from scratch as long as I've got that. The van! Can blow up what?
Foreign cars, you just can't trust them, can you?
No! No! No!
Bravo!
Everybody all right?
Yes.
So he was one of them too, eh?
Oh, he had us all fooled. Oh, David.
Oh, the cops will have him by now, I expect, miss. They're down there picking up the others by the truckload. Oh, sorry, we're late.
Oh, David.
David. Sheethead.
That's right.
I am sorry.
Don't be sorry. Be sorry when I marry a stranger. Don't be sorry when I don't. So you blew up that van?
Yeah, love. Sorry about the geraniums.
Oh, that's all right.
So what happened here? How'd you get rid of all of those?
Oh, we scared them off. It was Charlie's plan that we all acted out. First, Ellen and Kathy went upstairs, and then they conked David over the head with one of them cocaine medals, just like that King Buddy used to do. And then Charlie went, woo! And Ellen went and scooched him to the floorboard.
Oh,
he was real scared.
Well, it would be, yeah.
And it was a pretty crazy day for hearing one thing led to another, and then... Oh, look. Give me one second.
Yeah,
honey, don't you grieve.
Oh, I'm not grieving. I'm just having thoughts about this and that. Listen, I watched you defending this place. You are not going to move out of this house.
I ain't?
No, because I'm going to stay here with you.
You are?
Yeah, we're going to get this place going again, you and me. And Ellen, too, if you want. How about that, Ellen? Maybe you could do that brickwork.
Yeah, sure. You know, I was just thinking today about how this place could use like a brick porch over the brick walls around all them trees.
All right. We'll stay then.
Good, it'll be like having kids. I always did want to see kids running around here.
Well, you just keep your eyes open.
What?
Say something later.
And we could get brick birds.
Brick birds?
Yeah.
What kind of birds?
You know, like those great big ones.
Great big brick birds?
Yeah.
Well, if Ellen thinks it'd be nice, then I might be inclined to believe him.
All right.
All right, then. Now, Charlie, I'd hate to think what would have happened if you hadn't been here. I'm going to miss you to no end.
Oh, we all will.
Yeah. I miss you, too. Go leave.
Yeah.
Charlie, could I have a word with you, please? Just let me be a minute. I'm sorry.
Oh, that's all right. Let's go to the kitchen.
1 minute, that's all. Look, Charlie... I don't know how to say this quite, and I didn't think now would be the right time for it, but perhaps it is after all. This came here this morning. So you see, if you'd like to stay here a few days or more, it won't make much of a difference now, will it?
Straznia, Bolishnia, Mavra. Talu, Mavra. Talu.
Charlie, are you all right?
Yes,
All right, yes.
Charlie, talk to me.
I talk. 1, 2, 3, hello.
Charlie.
Excuse me, I just need to get the... Charlie? What is it?
Oh, he said some bad news, I'm afraid. Came this morning.
What is it, Charlie? Can you tell me? Can you whisper it to me? In English, Charlie. Oh, Charlie. I guess we both had our losses today, haven't we?
I've told him he can stay a bit longer if he likes. I can fix it on my end.
How about that, Charlie? You want to stay here a while? Charlie?
Look, Charlie, I ought to tell you. I'm a bit worried for him. I ought to tell you. He's not what he seems. Sure. I mean...
I think I know.
You do?
Come on, baby. We'll take care of you.
I stay?
That's right. You stay. And maybe if we work real hard, you won't be talking with any accent at all anymore.
That may take long.
Well... we've got all the time in the world.
Bet, I'm having a drink. And I never drink alone. On me.
Oh, what was in that telegram he had?
It was from the hospital. It was his wife.
Oh, his wife, did she die?
Well, no, it was from his wife. She recovered completely and ran off with a proctologist.
Oh, well, real life's awful hard sometimes.
It is, Bet. It is that. Blasney, Blasney.
Blasney, Blasney.
Thank you. That was so good.
That was Ron's fake level funny.
That's wild.